I remember my cousin giving me her phone number, and I was quite nervous actually to just give her a call and talk to her, but plucked up the courage and phoned her, and the conversation, I can't remember how long it lasted, but it was a very long conversation. I have no idea what we spoke about, but I do remember that the conversation just flowed, and we arranged the date. I can't remember the precise date. It was in May sometime.
We met on a bank holiday, Sunday before a bank holiday.
We met up around 12 in the afternoon, and I met her at the interchange, and I was just waiting. I was just waiting for her, and then I saw her for the first time with a summer dress on and curly hair, and I thought, very nice indeed, very nice.
The first thing that I noticed when I met Rakesh on our first date were his eyes. He has lovely eyes. We ended up spending 8 hours together. Usually my dates only last for about 30 minutes if I can get an excuse and run out. But yeah, there was just something about him. He made me feel special. He made me feel like, you know, what I was saying was important and that he was really interested, whereas a lot of guys don't really do that. They just want to talk about themselves all the time. But, you know, he came across as a very genuine, caring and loving person.
Before I knew it, it was dark, and she had to catch the 10 o'clock train. That's a 10-hour date. That is a long date. She actually did ask me before we got to the station, do you want to see me again? When are we seeing each other again? And I tried to play it cool, to be honest. Yeah, you have to, don't you? But deep down, definitely, definitely yes.
After our first date, I already knew that he was the one for me. I didn't want to look anymore. I'd just about managed to get the last train home on our first date, and my brother came to pick me up from the station because there were no buses running. And I couldn't stop smiling all the way home. He texted me a few days later asking if he wanted to meet up with me again. And I said, yeah, fine, you come to Manchester, that's fine, we can see each other at the weekend. So he came to Manchester, we spent the day together and had a really great day out where we got to know each other a little bit better, felt a bit more relaxed with each other, and held hands for the first time as well. So yeah, we had a really great day, and then he went home and I went home, and then on the Sunday, he surprised me by driving all the way to my house.
I drove up to Ashton drove up to her house, but well, actually it was the end of her street. I wasn't ready to meet her parents yet or her siblings. And we just spent a few hours together, just went to a pub and just chatted away again. So from then on, we were regularly seeing each other. Her parents and my parents were both itching to meet her, and her parents were itching to meet me.
Rakesh's mum and dad first met my parents in the November of the year that we met.
We arrived at my dad's house with my parents, and they met for the first time, and everything went swimmingly. It was fine. We all got on like a house on fire, and my parents, like Mita's parents, were anxious to know when the date was, the big day, and they were pushing for it straight away. They wanted us to get married the following April, and this is October, November time we're talking about. We've barely known each other for 6 months.
Well, I feel really nervous at the moment, and the only thing that's actually keeping me sane is probably Rakesh, because he's in the same boat and he knows exactly what I'm going through. But, you know, it is excitement and, you know, nerves and a lot of planning that's gone into this, and we just want everything to go right on the day.
So I'm really happy. I'm really looking forward to this wedding now. I hope everything's working out and running its course like it should. We both knew that we were going to get married to each other because I'd found my ideal match, and I hope she feels the same way.
I love him. I'm really happy.
I love her.
He's the one.
She's definitely the one. And I can't wait to live the rest of my life with her.
Thank you to my mum and dad and to Rakesh's mum and dad for being really supportive and helping us through everything and helping us with all the organisation.